Oh, no, there's somebody. I didn't see the call. I'm trying to focus on the camera. K1FK FFK. Don't know who he is. Don't know if some of these guys are D-Star, C4 FM. Most of those radios are also APRS enabled. Anytone 878 UV 2 Plus lets you enter the world of APRS, transmit, receive on analog as well as digital. Okay, to begin with, we're going to have to set up some APRS channels or channel, whatever you prefer. I'll show you what I have in my code plug. Here's an example of what I have. I have APRS receive on in a upper right-hand corner. The transmit receive frequency is 144.39. And here in Vermont, the DigiPeters use a PL tone of 62.5. I believe that is required for all across America. If you look here, I have the scan list. This little APRS channel goes to my Shark RF zone, but it allows me to just simply go to an APRS channel. If I'm out and about with that HT, I want it on high power, 25 kilohertz. I want the APRS report type analog. That's over on the left-hand side. Analog APRS push-to-talk mode at end of transmission. That works far better than beginning of transmission. So keep it at end of transmission. Here are the channels I built in my code plug. I have quite an extensive code plug. If you want it, you can go to bridgehub.com and download it there. But anyways, here we have APRS raw, APRS mute, APRS voice alert, APRS input, negative input positive, UHF channel, and a UHF digital. And I got these UHF channels off of APRS.org. So I assume with this video that you have some knowledge and skills of the computer programming software that's required to run the Anytone radio. So I went into my zone section and I created an APRS zone and then imported those seven channels there. And then I have it default one VFO and dual VFOs, A and B, mute and raw. I don't know how you can set yours up, but that's what I do for example. So if you want to scan those, you can do that. If you're not going to scan the channel and you're just manually going to rotate the knob, there's probably no reason to create a zone. So when you click in the zone, this is what comes up, and this is how I have mine set. Raw, mute, voice alert, input negative, input positive, UHF, and the UHF digital. And then you click OK, and you're done pretty much for this part. Here's my list of digital DMR digital channels. These are the most common ones around the country I could find. 510, 670, 146, 510, 79, 700, 65, and these other ones I found somewhere else on some website, so I just added them in to the respective frequencies, and everything is digital. But let me get to one of the channels, the setups, and I'll show you further. So let's pick the DMR 510 since it's the top of the list. Transmit receive frequencies 145.510. We chose the channel type digital. Transmit power, I'm going to put turbo. Transmit permit, since it's a simplex, always, I don't want to be polite. Scan list, I made a DMR simplex zone, scan list and zone. APRS report type is digital. Digital APRS push to talk option mode on. Digital APRS report channel 2. I'll show you where that comes in effect in the APRS tab a little bit further. I need to laugh because this is overwhelming. It's a lot of information. Exclude channel from roaming. No, I don't want it roaming. And DMR mode, because we're not going through a repeater, we're not going through a hotspot, is simplex. So if we go over to the right-hand side, we have the talk group, which is 99. which is DMR Simplex. I labeled them my code plug. My radio ID is AA1PR Portable. In this case, you can choose your color code, your time slot, but whoever you talk to is going to have the same. And then we go down, and I have ranging enabled. I'll show you a little information afterwards what slot suit is about. I'm not too sure what call confirmation or SMS confirmation is, but call confirmation, if you key up, then the radio holds back for, I think it's 10 or 20 seconds, milliseconds, I don't remember, and it has to make sure that you're actually allowed to transmit, which defeats the whole purpose of us being amateurs. That must be a commercial feature that's carried over. So anyways, we have ranging engaged. That's what you need for the digital channels. If you look at the top, APRS receive is off. It has to be off. Ranging will not work if you turn that off on. So anyways, let's hit OK, hit save, and let me show you that other information that you're going to need. And here's what it tells you down below in the box. I don't know if anybody's noticed that, but if you click APRS receive on a digital channel, it says between two Anytone transmit and receive radios, a GPS on, radio will show the distance between them. If transmit radio is GPS on but receive radio GPS off, radio will show coordinates of transmit radio. But then that's an analog. And then we notice it says, when digital APRS receive is on, the radio is not able to receive SMS, ranging, and alarm. So we're in the digital channel. So
it has to be off.
So once you've done that, I recommend you hit File, Save, Backup Everything, or hit the little white disk symbol underneath Save, and save everything that way. Save often. Hit Save. Can never hit that Save button too many times. So anyways, we're going to need you to go down to underneath Common Settings at the very bottom and open up the APRS tab. If you haven't had that opened up, you're going to go to Tools, scroll down to the settings there, and click the box for APRS, GPS, APRS Receive, and if you want Bluetooth on your radio enabled or whatever, hit all those and hit OK as well and get to this tab. I think the easiest way to do this, we're going to break this APRS tab up into sections. So I put color bars there. So we have red, yellow, blue, green, purple. Let's proceed through them one at a time, and I'll show you, because I've seen other videos in the past. A couple years ago when I got my 868, 878, the videos showed wrong information. So hopefully I can help you correct that information. So we're going to start in the red section, upper left-hand corner. Manual transmit intervals. Say your radio just sent out an APRS transmit data stream. You didn't see it. So the manual transmit interval, if you set that for 60, which is 60 seconds, 1 minute, it's not going to allow you to manually send another data stream for another 60 seconds. Go as low as 30. I don't remember what the highest setting is, but I'll use 60 just in case if I'm getting in a rough area. You may want to try to send a manual data stream to make sure that I'm being tracked. So APRS auto transmit, I find traveling in Vermont's topography, and it doesn't work all the time. 2 minutes is good. Support for roaming on, fixed location beacon. My default, when I just opened up this code plug and was working on this, is on. I recommend you shut that off. Unless you're going to sit at your house and never travel, never take your HT anywhere, then you can leave it on and you can manually put that in, and I'll show you in the next session. But if you're going to take your HT out and about, shut fixed location beacon off. APRS alternate data, I chose feet over meters. APRS distant time, I chose 3 seconds. Let's proceed. Now we're going to work on the fixed location part. That's the stuff with the yellow bar. So if you manually leave the fixed location beacon on, that tab on, then you can come down here and edit your latitude, longitude, north and east settings. If you're never going to go anywhere, you're just going to use your HT, your radio, in one location, Yeah, send out a fixed location beacon. But if you're going to go somewhere and use it mobile portable, keep that off and don't even bother filling in the information in the yellow section. Now this digital section in the upper right-hand corner, where I have the green bar, may look kind of confusing. But if you look back where we made the digital channels earlier in the video, you're going to see that we have APRS 310999. That's the one it uses through Brandmeister to send you data information through the system. So report slot, we're all going to set these in report slot. That's the easiest one than going back to your code plug and trying to remember if you use time slot 1 or time slot 2. And they're all private calls. So number 2 channel is DMR 500, 3 DMR 670, 4 DMR 146510. And again, they got these all from the channels that we made up for digital DMR contacts. And then the last one is number 8, the UHF digital channel, which also uses Talk Group channel 99. That's what uses DMR Simplex. So 310999 is through Brainmeister, through your hotspot, through Brainmeister repeaters. And I'm not sure if it works through DMR Mark repeaters. I've never tried it here in the state of Vermont. But if you're on Simplex, DMR Simplex uses the Talk Group 99. Let's progress. We're going to start off in the blue section. And let me tell you this first part. APRS transmit tone. The default is off. Leave it off unless you like listening to the data stream. On the new 878 UV2 Plus that we're working on, if you turn that on, there's no way to mute it. On the older 878s, I'm not sure about the 860, I've sold mine, you could turn the volume pot, the volume knob down, and it would mute it. If you turn the volume knob down on the UV2 Plus, it still sends the data stream about 3/4 volume out of your radio speaker. So anyways, to call, you have to have a call sign in here. Find a local digipeater near you, find its call sign, find its SSID number, and put it in here. You cannot leave it blank. I don't know if there's a default like a couple other guys and other channels claim that works, but that doesn't work. They're lying to you. Digipeters around here in Vermont, K1 EQX and Mount Equinox in Manchester Center uses -7. So I use my call sign under your call sign, AA1PR, and I also use a -7. And I have the little person symbol as I'm portable. I'm not in a car. Guess if I go mobile, I could change it. And for my sending text, I just have my call sign -7. A little information that denotes it's the UV2 Plus Bluetooth and I'm on APRS. I might change that at a later date to something, but that's the default where I kept it. So our transmission frequency, because we're on analog APRS, is 144.39. Transmit delay, I don't want any. Set subtone. Yes, we need a tone to access a repeater. All digipeaters are 62.5, last I knew. DCS, that's always on by default, so I left that alone. Pre-wave time, I set to 20. Transmit power, I want a high. My digipeater path, wide 1-1, wide 2-2. Do not put a comma between the 1-1 and the wide 2.2. Leave those tight together. Some people only use wide 2.2 or 2-2. Some people use wide 1-1, but I find a combination of two works best. So if we go over in the purple section, the default is all these are on. I just left them on. Not sure if you want to change them later down the road. Do you want the position? Not sure what the mic E is. Objects is, you know, whether they're in a car, they're portable, they're on a cell phone. Not sure what item is. The message is your sending text. The weather report, if they're enabled, maybe you might get a weather report. NEMA report, that's the GPS information. Status report, others. I just left them all on. I want to see what we can get off of this radio.
Sitting here in Manchester, Vermont, took a ride down here by Mount Equinox where the DigiPeter is, testing out the APRS on RAW. I'm getting information. KD2AVD, I think that was. Have to review the video later and see what we seen on screen. I think some of that traffic we hear is the actual DigiPeter. Let's go into APRS info. Oh, so we heard KD2ADY, KD9MIL, N1GMC, KC3PJE, K2DDL. I think that's a club out of Schenectady. W2WCR, that's out of New York. KC3, these must be, could be repeating all back to DigiPeters. It's here in the back. But we have it set up and it's working. But I'll do a screenshot, see if I can find myself on the APRS.fi map. So just going to try to key up here and send out a signal. Don't know if I made it. Brought my older 878 UV Bluetooth, and it's making the DigiPeter. But for some reason, this one, I think with the stock rubber ducky, just doesn't have enough oomph. Oh, it's been about a half hour. I've been sitting here having some burger and fries. Not that I need them, but those must be DigiPeters. KD2AYD, KD9MIL, GMC, ones we had before. KB2VLP, that's new. That's Saratoga. KFIPGZ, that's new. KM2O, that's new from last time. That's Equinox. That's what I got my code plug set to. W1WWW. Interesting call. W1UWS. That's Mount Ascutney. Saratoga. K1YMI. Don't know him or her. Oops. EQX again. Anyways, it bumped me out of there. So anyways, it works, it receives. I was hoping to catch somebody else with an Anytone that had ranging enabled. That way it would give me a ranging symbol. But you know what I'll do? I'll set up the two, this Anytone 878, the UV2 Plus, and my old 878 UV Bluetooth with a blue button. And I'll just send a DMR Simplex ranging thing across so we can see what happens. I'll do it indoors for my apartment. Unfortunately, I won't have any GPS lock, but yeah, you'll be able to see what happens. At least get an idea what could potentially you could see. Once you get into your analog APRS book, like we'll choose this guy for example, you can see the ranging information. All the information that's available. That was the 878 UV Bluetooth on the left, the 878 UV 2 Plus on the right. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, hit that bell notification for future videos. Please support us on patreon.com/simplyhamradio. Use our Amazon affiliate link, simplyhamradio-20, for any and all purchases on Amazon. And if you're going to buy anything out of BridgeCom, use our BridgeCom affiliate link to help support the channels. Keep us making videos and buying some new product down the road for those videos. 7-3.